Hi guys, today we are going to delve into Mesh Fusion Pro and I will show you how to use it to optimize your Unity project. In the preparation and the quick start sections I will give you the necessary basics and then we will take a closer look at the components of Mesh Fusion Pro. Let's get started. You need to install two packages, Burst and Collections, into your project. For objects in your scene to be combined using Mesh Fusion Pro, you need to have two components, Mesh Fusion Controller and Mesh Fusion Source. Mesh Fusion Pro supports three types of objects, static, dynamic and load groups. These objects can already be in the scene, or they can be created in runtime or even be procedurally generated. All you need to do is attach a desired component to the object. You can create a Mesh Fusion Controller through a special menu in the Tools tab. For an object to be successfully combined, it must have Mesh Render and Mesh Filter, or Load Groups components. Put the static Mesh Fusion Source component on static objects, dynamic Mesh Fusion Source on dynamic ones, and load Mesh Fusion Source to Load Groups. After you attach one of three components on an object, you can see a message if such an object is not compatible with the Mesh Fusion Pro system, and also the reason for the incompatibility. If your object is interactive, you can additionally attach the source tracker component on such an object. For static objects and load groups, this component will work like this. If the original object is destroyed, part of the combined mesh will also be destroyed. If you put source tracker on a dynamic object, it will track the movements of this object. Manually attaching Mesh Fusion Source on all objects you want to combine would not be very convenient. Therefore, you can do this using the selection tool in Mesh Fusion Controller. If you click on Assign Auto, Mesh Fusion Pro will automatically attach static Mesh Fusion Source component on all static objects. You can turn on the Draw Gizmo flag to see which static Mesh Fusion Source components are on the scene. Also, you can select the objects you want to add and press the Assign Selected button. The same rules applies to the Load Sources section. A more serious approach should be taken to the selection of dynamic sources. As moving dynamic part of a combined object takes a lot of resources, therefore I advise you to select only those objects that move very rarely. With the selection tool you can assign only objects with a rigid body component. But in reality, you can attach the dynamic Mesh Fusion Source component on any object where there is a Mesh Render and Mesh Filter. In the Incompatible Sources tab, you can see a list of objects that are not compatible with the Mesh Fusion Pro system for some reason, and also view the reasons of the incompatibility. For Mesh Fusion Pro to work correctly, I recommend disabling static batching. If you see that Mesh Fusion Pro cannot combine some objects because the mesh is not readable, you can fix this automatically with the Make Mesh Readable button. Let's look more closely at the Mesh Fusion Source parameters. Combine at start. This flag indicates whether to combine this object as soon as it appears on the scene or you want to do it manually. On Combine Error. This is the action that will happen if an error occurs during the combine. After Combine Action. The action that will be performed after the object is successfully combined. Each of three mesh fusion sources has on combined finished event and two public methods, async undo controller and undo combine. With these methods, you can control the combine process and better integrate Mesh Fusion Pro into your project. In the Mesh Fusion component, you can set such a parameter as a cell size. In the Unity, even if a small part of the object falls into the field of view of camera, the object will be drawn entirely. To solve this problem, Mesh Fusion Pro divides the scene into cells and combines objects in these cells. Therefore, it is important to choose the optimal cell size value. Now let's talk about lightweight meshes. In Unity, the standard vertex buffer in memory looks like this. But with the advanced mesh IP, you can change the size of the vertex buffer. Thanks to this, memory usage is reduced and mesh processing speed is increased. I recommend you try using lightweight meshes, but if this leads to defects, use the standard representation. This concludes the information about Mesh Fusion Pro. I hope this tutorial was useful for you, and I hope Mesh Fusion Pro will be useful for you. Thank you for watching, goodbye.